In this lecture, we'll be covering David Hardiman's perspective, that is subaltern perspective, which has talked about the role of peasants and Indian tribes. So he was one of the major advocates of the subaltern historiography movement in India. Now, as we know that subaltern historiography, the word subaltern given by Gramsci, it talks about how the things that have happened in history, they shape the present or the future. He was interested in the history of South Asia and especially during the period of colonialism. He wanted to understand the impact of colonial rule on the rural society, how it affected the peasants, how it affected the tribal people, and also the people who had power and authority. You know, his studies, the way he tried to understand about the rural society, it threw some light on the role of local power structure and also nationalism. Now, he examined the role of local peasants and their activities and how the Adivasis who protested against the exploitation which was done by the local peasants, how their assertions during the colonial time affected the Western India. So his study was mainly focused on Kheda district in Gujarat. He used ethnographic approach and he studied many archival sources. He analyzed various movements of Western India, and to understand them, he had to go through a lot of archival sources. That is, he went through a lot of literature that was published in the past. He is one of the pioneers who promoted subaltern studies in India. Now, his approach was to associate theory with action because he was studying ethnography. That means he was going back in time and reading all the literature available in the past, but he also associated that theory with action. Another important point to notice here that he was interested in Gandhian ideology. How Gandhi was doing things. He was very much interested in knowing what will be the repercussions of that ideology. Now, his famous works include the study of Gujarat, that is, he studied the Devi movement, and another work is Feeding the Banyas. Let us understand this. So, his article, Adivasi Assertion in South Gujarat, the Devi movement. Now, please sit back and relax and listen to it like a story. So, what happened in the year 1922 and 23, the Devi movement took place in Gujarat. Now, what was this movement? A lot of landlords, liquor shop owners, and moneylenders. So, these are the influential and powerful people of the rural society. They started manufacturing a lot of liquor. And they started distributing it among the tribals. Okay. So, in order to curb that, in order to raise their voice, they started a tribal movement, which was the Devi movement. Now, what happened? They slowly started distributing and the Adivasis started consuming alcohol very frequently. Slowly, it started affecting their health. Then it started affecting their wealth because they were always intoxicated, they were always suffering, their health was not working properly, so they were not able to work. And as a result, the movement, Devi movement, came into being. So it was against the harmful effects of liquor on the people of their tribal community. The Colonial Abkari Act of 1878, it banned all the local manufacturing of liquor, and the central distillery was established at the headquarters because there was a lot of manufacturing done, and when the supply would be too much, because the manufacturing is too much, the supply would be too much and the demand will increase because they will become addicted. So the Abkari Act of 1878, which had banned all local manufacturing, it was broken. That law, that act was not taking into consideration. So what happened was these powerful people, moneylenders and manufacturers, they knew that the government was corrupt. Okay, mind you, it was the colonial government at that time. So they started bribing them, and when they bribed them, they were made to get licenses very easily. It was very easy for them to get the license to manufacture the liquor, which was banned, but they still manufactured it and they distributed it. So the lower caste people, and especially the tribals, they were the victims of poor health due to this free distribution of liquor. And this distribution was very heavy in nature because they had a monopoly and they were greedy for profits. So as a result, the Adivasis, they became addicted and they could not work. They were suffering from poor health and they were indebted because they did not even have the money to get treatment from hospitals. And they were under a lot of debt. But as the time passed, they started understanding that this is a trap and they are being exploited. They are being forced to consume liquor that they do not want to, and they are becoming addicted to it. But because the opposition, the party which involved the money lenders and the manufacturers, they were so influential, they were so powerful that they could not protest. But they started to understand, they gained this consciousness that we have to protest among the subaltern groups as well, because this feeling of exploitation, it had turned into an outrage, because they thought that we have to do something, otherwise we will keep on getting exploited. So this Devi movement or Salabhai, what happened was, in the same year, an epidemic of smallpox broke out in the coastal areas of Gujarat. So it mainly affected the subaltern fishermen communities. And because it was near the coastal areas, they started believing that the goddess or Devi, she was very angry. And they started doing a lot of ceremonies and rituals. So because they were not educated, they were illiterate, and they believed in a lot of superstitions. So they started organizing a lot of ceremonies and rituals. And there was this woman who said that I can communicate to the goddess, and that she's telling me that we need to give up on drinking liquor and consuming non-vegetarian food. So because they were so scared, it was a situation of epidemic. So they believed that woman, that lady who said I can communicate to the goddess, and they stopped consuming liquor and meat. So this is how the movement of shamanism came into being, and it led to the boycott of liquor, because now that liquor was playing with their beliefs. They said that because we consumed your liquor, our goddess is angry with them, and they started social reforms among themselves. So earlier, when they were afraid to raise their voice, now they could raise their voice. They organized themselves and they started social reforms. At the same time, Gandhi was also there, and he was also experimenting with a lot of ideas, with a lot of movements. And that is when this group of tribals, it made alliance with the middle class, and the other nationalists, that is the Gandhian nationalists of Gujarat, brought them and made them a part of the nationalist movement. So something that started on a very small scale, it started being on a bigger platform, and it started changing into a nationalist movement. The illiterate tribal people who had no voice were now heard and were now a part of something, a bigger revolution. Therefore, these Adivasis were considered as the passive objects of colonial policy. Now, coming to the conclusion, we can say that Hardiman studied in detail about the local areas of Khera district in Gujarat among the peasants and the tribal people of that area. His ethnographic account reveals that middle peasantry is relatively radical as compared to poor and landless Adivasi peasants of the villages in the district. We know that they were poor and landless, and that is why they could not raise their voice. At the same time, if the victims had been the middle peasantry, it would have been something else. But at the same time, in the end, the Adivasis, they got a platform because of the help of Gandhian nationalists. Let us discuss some questions. Who has made the statement caste is closed class and class is open caste? This is said by David Hardiman. Please understand this. This is very important for examinations. Question number two, who is the author of the book Feeding the Baniya, Peasants and Usurers in Western India? So this is given by David Hardiman. In this book, which is an important, another important work other than the Devi movement, he has talked about the relationship between peasants and baniyas and how baniyas have always gotten the economic but also support from the government. They've got support from economic perspective, that is from influential people, but also from the state. And that is why they arranged to, keep on continuing their monopoly. So I hope you got the lecture. Thank you.